Welcome to all. I am Professor A. Rokode, going to deliver video lecture on the topic design of combine harvester. So combine harvester, it is a machine designed for harvesting, threshing, separating, cleaning and collecting the grain while moving through the standing crop. So it may be used for following purpose. It cut the crops, threshes the beets, the kernels from the heads, separate the kernels from the straw, clean and grate the grain before eluting into the storage tank. So this is the schematic diagram of the combine harvesters. So this is the reel, this is the cutter bar, this portion is called as feeding auger, this is the chain conveyor, this is first cylinder, this is second cylinder, then these are the oscillating rakes, these are the different elevators, these are the different blowers and straw which is transfer and grain which is storage in the tanks. Then let us go through it, design processor. First is the design of header. So compare the header length with the length of the drum and the surface conveyor. LHST will test to see is less than 1.0.1.2. For small combine, this value is less than 1:2. LH is less than 2.1 meter. For medium combine, it is in between 2.1 to 3 meter. For large, it is greater than 3 meters. Now the capacity is harvesting cereal is given by this formula. These are these particulars. Next is the design of crop conveyor. The combine output is equal to header output, conveyor output, thresher outputs. So output of the chain conveyor Qc is equal to Lc Wc eta S Vc into gamma n. So these are these particulars. Next is the threshing mechanism. Threshing mechanism use a rasbar and spectrum cylinder. If wheat and barley crop is used, the rasbar velocity is 30 to 32 meter per second, spectrum 20 to 30 meter per second. For the different crop, it is given here in the tables. Next is determine the feed rate of the thresher on the basis of grain output and straw grain ratio. The delta is equal to Qs upon Kg, where Qs is the straw output, Kg is the grain output. Then determine the revolution of the threshing per cylinder. N is equal to peripheral velocity divided by pi d. B is the diameter of the cylinder in meter. Then determine the length of the drums. Q is equal to 0.25 RPN L d into K 1 plus delta dash. These are these particulars. By rearranging this formula, we can determine the length of the drum. This is alternative formula also. Q is equal to KLR into RB. Next is the calculation of power requirement. P is equal to Q V2 minus V1 upon V1 plus C plus MV into NV cube. These are his particulars. Next is the threshing efficiency determined by 100 minus percentage of unthreshed grain. Next is the cleaning mechanism. So cleaning mechanism includes straw walkers. So length of the straw walkers is determined by using this formula. L percentage is equal to Fs 100 into E raised to minus EU Ls delta H into Q. Then straw layer thickness H is equal to Q into 1 minus delta dash WVVM into rho S. Next is the cleaning unit includes screening, sieving and chuffing. So this is the width of the sieve. W sieve is equal to 0.9 minus 0.92 WSV. A specific load on the sieve is equal to 0.15 minus 0.17 kg per centimeter decimeter sieve width. So area is equal to Q dash upon Q dash sieve. Next is the cleaning efficiency is equal to percentage I upon J into 100, where I is the weight of the whole grain. J is equal to weight of the whole material. In power requirement, WC is equal to WR, WN, WW. Where WC is the total power required for operating the combine kilowatt. WR is the power required for rolling of combine. W is the power required for driving working parts. And WW power required for driving working parts at no load. WR is equal to PV into NTR into NS. These are his particulars. WW. W0 into Q, here there is particulars. So this is the complete all about the design process of combine harvester. I ended my video lecture. Thank you very much.